Hi guys, my name is Sarvansh and thank you for watching my the other videos about SSCLM tutorial. So today's topic is about the users and the user collection. So why we gonna use it, user collection, I'm going to explain in this video. So let me start this video. First we can go to asset and compliance. Here you can see in it my console. I am under the asset and compliance. So here I have the users. So these users already it was discovered and so I have these many users here, and now here I have the user collection. So first I will tell you how you can manage your the user collections here. So here you can go and can create so you can create a folder based on your company requirement. Like you have IT, so you can create a folder IT, and if you expand it you can see in it here. And if you have a HR, sorry, so create first a folder, and here you can create a like a HR, here I got the group. And if you want to create the other group, you can create like any other thing, help desk or anything. If you want to categorize your groups like the countries, so you can give the BLR, or you want to give the Delhi, so you can create a some other group as well like the Delhi. And under these group you can mention it up to you how you're gonna manage your groups. And you can create a groups by your country location and company locations based on their department, or how you're gonna manage it up to you. And now I will show you, like I have the BLR under this. I want to create one more subgroup, like I want to create SSCM team. Okay, so my the all the collections under comes like a SSCM team or like a package deployment. So I can mention like a application deployment. So I have created like this group application deployment. So whichever I'm gonna keep a user collection, so here I will keep. So that's how you can manage your groups, user collection, and that folder hierarchy. So under you can go like can create a groups, and under you can create a subgroup as well. So this is the hierarchy you can create and manage your infra. Now let me explain why we need a user collection. So user collection is a combination of some users, or can be a more user. So it's a collection where we can keep it our users. So user collection is required to deploy any application on that particular users, that is a part of our user collection. So but why we need the user collection, again the question is, and why we are deploying a application to user collection. So such requirement like a application to be work on the particular user, that's why we are deploying on a user collection. Let me give you a scenario. I have the few users which application deploy to on their user ID. So whenever they will log in on any of the device, that application will automatically install on particular the device. It could be a laptop or desktop. So that's why we are deploying the application on users. Now if the I deployed an application to one particular user, and as I told you, wherever that user will log in, it will install automatically particular for that user. So if the user log in one laptop and it application install, again the new user came which is not part of that collection. If he log in and trying to access that application, he cannot, that application cannot visible to another user, and that other user cannot access that particular application. So that's why we are using the user group. Okay, so now let me show you something how we can create the user collection. So I'm gonna use it for scenario application deployment. Okay, under here I am gonna create a one collection. So this is for, I am taking a example, I'm gonna deploy Adobe. Okay, so Adobe Reader, just for example I give in the name and click on that browse. So always taking all users, or if up to you from where you want to fetch your information. So I have, as I am in a testing environment, I have the all users. So let me select it, let me go to next, and here is a, so many things are there. So I will explain you one by one, like a direct rule, a query rule, direct category rule, device category rule, include, and this. So let me go first with the direct rule, how I'm gonna create it. Click next, and here is user resource name, and here I can give like some users I have, starting and ending by the SSEM. So it will fetch all the information. So here I have two users, one is this, one's AD, and one is the SSEM admin and SSEM. So I take in two users here and it closed. If you want to add some more users, okay, you go in the same way and you can select here, like I have a user AD. Let me search it. No, I didn't find out. Okay, let me go with this way. Orange AD slash. Let me try this. Okay, so there is a something wrong. Let me go and check the username properly. Let me next. Okay, let me cancel this. Already I added two users, so it should be like a 10. Okay, so let me search it. 10/AD. Let me go and check the users what it is. This user I can take completely name, or I can do the things like, where is my screen here, or better I can go with the percentage AD and percentage again, so it will filter with the AD name. So I came it with the AD. Okay, and the administrator user also there. Let me go with the AD only, and now I am able to add it. So this is how you can create your AD group, direct rule. So I added the machines directly to in this collection. This is called direct membership collection, where you are adding the machines manually. Okay, so let me go and show you the next scenario, how we can add based on the query rule. So to create the query, I need the group name here. The data will come from the Active Directory. So I need a group in the Active Directory. Let me go to an Active Directory. So here is my AD server, and I'm gonna manage my company. So I need some specific OU, and then inside I will keep my collections which I am gonna use for the application deployment on user group. So let me plan it something. It's a new fresh infra. Go to here, and here I will create it one OU. So this OU will be like something application, SSEM application deployment. Okay, so I create it. Here I have a group. Inside that, I can create my the groups. So groups will be something like where I am going to add my machines, and this SSEM application deployment OU, I will keep my all the collection which I am going to use in my SSEM. Okay, so let me give some name what application you're gonna deploy it. Like suppose you want to deploy Adobe Reader underscore Adobe Reader. Okay, so this should be like a global scope will be the global and group type will be security. So now here I have the my group name is Adobe Reader, and I'm going to deploy an Adobe Reader application to few of the users. So whichever users I'm gonna deploy Adobe Reader, I need to add under this group. Let me go and under the membership, suppose I want like the my SSEM users, how many users I do have, like okay, 2 users I have. Let me add this. And the next, if you have some more users, if you are in a production, obviously you have thousand lakhs of users. So whichever that application going to deploy, you can add it here, your user's name. Okay, so this is the general information. Description, you can give like why gonna use it, something application description, or here you can define your owner as well. O-W-N-E-R, owner equal to I have the AD is like Wunsch AD. Wunsch AD slash SSEM account. So my this account will be owner for this particular group. You can give the comma and give the other username as well. Like again, I can give the one more owner here. And that these users will be owner for this group, this AD group, and these users can add the machines here. So this is my the one part is 2 machines added here, and it's a member of. If you want to be the member of, you can make it them. If you don't want it, up to you. So I added 2 machines. So my one part is done. From Active Directory, what I am gonna create the group first, and then it will discover to my SSEM. So basically, when you are running your infra, all things will be in a place. So no need to create it again. But I am showing you from starting. If it is not there, then how you gonna create it? So my the second job will be to discover these users in my SSEM. So let me go to the discovery administrator discovery method, and here I have the user discovery, and here this I was added for the testing. Let me remove it, and I can go here, browse it, and what I am giving the SSEM application. Okay, so if I'm selecting this OU, inside that all the users will discover automatically. If I give this and the discover object within the AD group. Okay, so just select this option, click OK, and now my SSEM is ready to discover groups and the users what I created in my AD. So let me click OK and let me run it once. Now I can go to the logs. So my logs is here, something AD user discovery. Let me reopen. There was some error. So it's gonna start. Okay, let's see whether it's able to discover or not. So what it was discovering, so this use this log, AD user discovery log, you can open and see from where it was discovering. 136. Okay, so it discovered so many things. Let us go to the last and check our group. So here is the group, SSEM application deployment. This is the group. is discovered in my SSEM. So now discovery is happened and I can add it to my, I can create my collection based on the query rule. So by the second phase is done, and now I am gonna show you the third stage to create a collection. So now we are in a stage to create a collection for Adobe Reader. So let me click, and here is Adobe underscore Reader, and I can just give the name AD based. Just I'm giving for to show you guys, don't give like in production AD base, you just need to give the application name. Here I created next, and here I'm gonna show you the query rule. So query, you can mention anything which you can remember, or it will show you in the query. Just give the any name. And here I have already written a query. You can use this query, or if you want like to write your own, so you can use. It's not a very tough. It's a very simple. Here you need to go open this. I will show you if you are in that screen. Like go from starting query rule and type it Adobe, and then you can create your own query. So here is something like you can use the table, select user resource, okay, and here will be, I am giving the user group name. So group name you can give, and the OU also you can give, user group name I am giving, okay, and then it's okay. Now the criteria, because I'm gonna give the where condition here, and again it will be select, and here will be user resource, and go to here again, you selected the condition group name. Okay, now it asking for the value. Okay, AD DNS admin, no, this I'm not gonna give. I am gonna give it like once zero slash, and what was the my group name here, just check it, Adobe underscore reader, Adobe underscore reader, reader, and just click OK. Select it and okay. So now my query is ready. If you want to check like how the query looks like, you go there and show the query. So this is what the query I have. So this query is generated, and now it will fetch the information from the AD group. Okay, so now this part is done, and I can go to the collection and show you. This is what the I created collection. You can refresh it, and I think discovery has not run it properly. Once it done, and you can see in the machine here how many the members count will be there. You can check it again query. Okay, so it's got change automatically, and this is what our the query. As I shows you here, I have already drafted, and it's gonna show you. So this is the ID, resource ID, and this user, and the domain from this. And where my the user group name. So this is the my group name what I have defined it here. So this is your query, where you gonna keep your group name, and I showed you how you can create the query itself. So no need to copy paste also, you can just do your own self. and this is the option is showing like how frequently your collection will be updating. So you can put it like a daily, so that collection will be updating daily in this particular time. So when the user is added in AD group, then second stage SSCM will do the discovery, and that user's detail will fetch to in SSCM, and later on at this particular time collection will execute the query automatically and it will update the user details in your group. So that's how guys you can create your user based collections. Now let me show you the another scenario is how you can create the other collection. So like what name I can give in, this is Adobe underscore reader and include collection. So I'm gonna show you the scenario where you can use the include collections. I click next, and here is include collection is something like where the collection already available and that you want to include in your SSCM console. Now click next, and here is which collection you want to include. So go that particular folder where we was under this here, and we created some users here and select whichever you want, click OK. So these users collection will include, and whatever users will available on these collection and this collection, it will reflect to in your new collection. So now you can give it time, daily I want to update it, and click on next and next and next. So this is how you can create your user collection, include collection, and here I can update it. So in this collection, three machines are there. This machine is still, machine is not reflecting, that will come. I think discovery is not run properly. So when you are in the production, it will come easily. So guys, keep at least one day difference when you are creating a AD group, and give a at least one day time to reflect in SSCM, and then start creating your collections. If you create collections also, it's not gonna any problem, it will update automatically, but after your discovery. So that's how we can create like a include collection. So now my count is 3, this count and this count is automatically added. And now let me show you the exclude collections. So Adobe reader underscore exclude collections. So how it gonna work? Here I do have okay, I'm giving the limiting collection, and okay, so now I want to show you the exclude collection, how it will work. So single exclude collection, don't use it. If you are having like exclude collection, how it gonna work, like you have added a few of the machines in direct membership rule, and you want to exclude one particular user collection, so you can do it, just exclude that collection. So I'm gonna exclude my the Adobe Reader, there are the three machines, and so I need the include collections also, or else it's not going to work. And I can take it from root. So I can I can just do this exclusion, exclude collection, and now I'm gonna do it include also here. So then you can see the difference. I'm using the all users group, and next, something mistake. Include, and here is this, selected this. Okay, so now I have the include this user and then exclude above user collection. So how it gonna change it, let's change my time also, how it gonna difference. Next, and okay now. So it's going to refresh, click here and click here, it will refresh automatically. Okay, it's not refresh, so just right click and refresh here. Now, so now you can see in it one users only, because in my Adobe Reader this I excluded for this collection. So here I have the four collection and minus my this users count, so whichever will match the users, and it will exclude it. So now I have only the one user. So that's how we can use our exclude collection. So there is a one more thing, which is device category rule. So this device category rule is something where we are using our MDM. So it's a mobile device management, and how we gonna use it. Then I don't have the this co-management part in my SCM, so this I cannot show you, but yeah, I can give you the example. Just go to here, create a collection, and Adobe Reader Adobe Adobe Reader, and this I can say device MDM, I can mention, go to here, and that limiting collection will be all user. Next, and now I'm gonna show you the device category rule. So here already I have created one rule for testing purpose. You can use that also, or if you want to create a new one, that you can click here and mention your the device category. So I created this one, I can show it's for the laptop, and here you can check it out your one day. And this automatically taking a query, and what kind of query it's taking, you can see in it here. Go here, and here what is mentioned inside this, go to show query, and here you can see in it, it's taken from this table, the where SMS system dot MDM device category equal to this. So when you are having your MDM device category, you can put it your ID, so it will automatically take in all the machines related to your this MDM device category ID. So let me click OK, and why this has happened, resource does not match the correction. Let me cancel it. It was working. Okay, next, and next, now close. So now you are having your MDM collections. So when you added, when you have a machine with that particular device ID, then automatically it will come and add it to this collections. So I don't have any MDM device ID, so it's not showing anything, it's showing the blank. It is not updating. So yeah, it's showing the zero as I was expected. So guys, you seen it how we can use the user user and user collection, how we can create the folders, and how we can manage it our collections, like direct membership rule, include, exclude, device management. So there are the four types of the four types category to create a collection, user collection. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video, and keep watching, please subscribe channel. Okay, thank you.